Hello, dear friends. Today we are going to draw the symbol of protection, moon peace, the hamsa with the white rose. Before we begin our drawing today, I would like to introduce myself. I'm Alina Smolyansky, a certified instructor of NeuroGraphica. Today we will be using the symbol of hamsa, another peace symbol like the white rose, and the elements of NeuroGraphica. Those who are completely new for the NeuroGraphica, the art of NeuroGraphica or NeuroArt, I would suggest looking some of my other videos that explain how to draw the NeuroGraphic line and around do roundings. I will cover very briefly how to do that, but if you would like to know more about it, I would suggest looking for my other videos that explain how to draw the NeuroGraphic line in more detail. Today, we will concentrate on drawing. And hamsa, the symbol that known from antiquity. It predates all the existing religions and probably one of the oldest signs of protection that were used from the very beginning, one of the earliest signs. The symbol is known as hamsa, it's the open hand, and is very popular in various cultures, specifically in the Middle East, North Africa, and India. It's typically shaped as an open hand. It could be symmetrical or asymmetrical, like a regular hand. It's used in jewelry, in amulets, in decoration, and souvenirs. Sometimes the hand could be shaped and hang or shown upwards and downwards. The word hamsa comes from the Arabic or Hebrew number 5, hamesh, is 5 fingers, and it could be symmetrical, as you can see on many of them, or as a more like a natural hand. Hamsa is probably one of the oldest known protective images, the hand itself. Today we talk about why hamsa is used in this symbol. The hamsa symbol was used as a protection, but also as the hand of blessing, teachings, independent really traditions. They also sometimes are signs that are drawn in the hand. And today I will talk about hamsa, which is also known by the names of the hand of Miriam, the hand of Fatima, or the hand of Mary. And in today's presentation, we will talk why these three names are associated with specifically with the symbol of hamsa. As you can probably understand, the hand is the greatest tool that allows us to develop as human beings together with a vertical spine and the brain. We can create various objects with our hands. We can play musical instrument, write, draw, perform various tasks. In all cultures, the hand symbolizes friendship and trust as well. The hand symbol has a long history. But when we talk about the hamsa, we associate it with the female hand. In Jewish tradition, the symbol of hamsa is known as the hand of Miriam. Miriam was a prophetess and the elder sister of Aaron and Moses. She is one of the most important figures in the Old Testament. Miriam appears in the Old Testament when the Israelites have left Egypt and crossed the Red Sea. Moses and Israelites sing a hymn to the power of God known as the Song of the Sea. But when they finished, Miriam, known as a prophetess, takes a tambourine and dances in place with other women singing the same hymn. This is probably one of the few occasions when women in the Bible acted on their own. 40 years that Israelites were wandered in the wilderness, they were also accompanied by so-called Miriam's well that supplied them with water. Miriam didn't enter the land of Israel. When she died, the well dried up. And you probably can understand the importance of the well and its connection to the woman. Muslims call this symbol the hand of Fatima. five fingers identify the five main virtues of this religion. They are pilgrimage, mercy, moderation, faith, and prayer. There is also a history of the origin of the image. According to legend, Fatima loved her husband very much. And one day, when she cooked dinner, he appeared home and brought another woman and said that she would be his other wife. Fatima was so upset that she forgot about the cooking and dropped the spoon and continued stirring food with her hand. However, this is not true because Ali, her husband, loved her so much that he married another time only after her death. Not much is known about Fatima, except that she was a beloved daughter of her father, and she was a model of mercy, devotion, honesty, and faithfulness. Her virtues were praised by many, and pointing her similarity and resemblance to the Prophet. And she died 6 months after her father. She was only 28 years old. Christians of the Middle East and North Africa gave the symbol another name, the Hand of Mary. The feminine principle, the image of woman, mother, the giver of life, is praised all over the world. The image of the Blessed Virgin Mary contains both the divine miracle of the birth, life, and the earthly path of an ordinary woman. Mary was married to an elderly widow, Joseph. According to legend, when she was praying, angel appeared to the girl, Archangel Gabriel, and announced that she would bear a son. The boy, according to Archangel Gabriel, became the savior of people, and whose Jewish people were expecting for a long time. This feast is known as a feast of an Annunciation. Little is known about life of Mary, except when she became mother of Jesus. She accompanied her son everywhere. She knew about his fate from the very beginning, and she followed him, and she had to deal with this and his fate. It's believed that Mary spent the remaining of her life after Jesus' death on Mount Athos, and the complex's monastery was built in that location. So we will think about it, whether the hand was used to ward off evil or bring good luck. The symbol has always been a symbol of patient faith, protection, and love. This hand symbol is so much as full of love, feminine, so gentle, so caring. Yet it's powerful, and that it literally can block all evil intention and protect from evil. And we will use the symbol of Hamsa, a hand, feminine hand, today, and also the another symbols to offer our protection, to give it and as a silent prayer, as a meditative prayer. And now I would like to invite you to begin our drawing. And before we continue with our drawing, I would like to explain very quickly what elements we're going to use today. Akiva, please, you know that we draw with regular markers. We're going to draw the neurographic line in addition to regular lines, like a sketch line. So the neurographic line is the line that doesn't repeat itself. It's not just intuitive, free-form, squiggly line, but the line that by definition doesn't repeat itself. This means that this portion doesn't resemble this portion and then this portion. You can draw it in any direction. Either, for example, you need to draw it almost like a straight line, like what we're going to do today. Just make sure that you move your hand slightly. So the line, when you, zoom in, is not even. Why we draw this kind of line, and it is called the neurographic line, I explained in some other videos. This one, we will just use this element. Also, the other element is rounding the corners. When we make soft corners, just as you can see here, four corners are formed by two lines crossing. So if you just draw the small curve, and you draw the line. So this is called rounding, and we need this element as well. So another element of neurographic art is a connection of all the elements. They're all connected with the neurographic line on our drawing. And we follow the formula, which is called the basic algorithm, that explains how to draw that. But that you do not need to know that. And I will guide you through, and I probably mention, but they're not as important right now, not for this class. This class, you will, if you wonder whether that's pure neurographica, I would say this is more neuro art, because it uses the element of neurographica, but also some figures and symbolism, and with more relaxed rules. So let's call it, that's not neuro art, that's based on neurographica. And with this, I will invite you to think about the theme that you're going to draw today. The theme and intention is also a very important element when we draw neurographica drawings, neurographic art. There's always an intention, there's always a theme when we draw neurographica. But it's not just because of pictures, but also it has intention. So my intention for today, it would be offering my support, peace of the world, my state of being calm, composed, thoughtful, and I will also offer this drawing as a prayer to contribute to peace in the world, stability in the world, calmness, composure, compassion. Oh, good feelings. And with this, we can start the drawing. So first we will begin with a hamsa. Hamsa, as I said, is a hand, and I will use my own hand to draw. So we will draw hand that's not symmetrical, and it's more like a hand. Place your hand. You can use a pencil or you can use a marker. Then I explain what I'm going to do. So I will outline my hand. I will use pencil. So here you have the element of a hamsa. Here it is. However, such element of, I want to increase it. And that's all which to, if we want to raise significance of some element in neurographica, we can always increase the size. So with this, I will increase the size. Just, that's why I drew it with a pencil, like this. So I'll just make it bigger, because my hand is small. Maybe it was a larger hand will be different, but I would like to increase the significance, and that's why I will make the size other hand, slightly larger. I just outline it, make it a little bit bigger. Now I will use a marker. You can use any color marker you want. I will prefer blue as a color of air, peace, water as well. And I will outline it, use it using the neurographic line. And if you have it, I will just erase the original image so it doesn't interfere with our drawing. So we have our hand. So now we can include the flower, the white rose. The white rose is the symbol of purity and love and peace. It was accepted that in the 20th century as a symbol of peace. And that's very important right now. So it's a simple way how to draw the rose. First, we will start in the middle of the hand, so that's the widest part. And also you can create as a spiral. So the rose begins as unfolding spiral. Okay. Okay, one, two, three, at least four spark. And then I'm taking it outside. So now we'll give you some petals. And now from the beginning, that's how unfolds, and the petals, unfolding petals. And one more here. So now with the drawing exist, we can start adding neurographic lines. Probably we'll continue from the center of the spiral. Spiral is like our symbol of power, unfolding energy. You can think about other symbols that you would like to include in a Hamsa. I'm focusing my energy and remaining calm. And also at the same time, I start rounding the corners. So please remember, you need to round the corners as much as you feel like. There is no rule in this kind of drawing, how whether you have to round all the corners or part of them, just based on your own feeling. Then you want more comfort, more rounding. If you feel fine, that's then you don't have to round every single corner. I feel these faces with a neurographic line, the line of consciousness. You can stop the drawing and work on your own. This is my drawing so far, and I would like to just outline just a little bit of blue color. To make the roses stand out more. Our rose. Also, I'd like to include some background. So what can I expect in the background? Any positive? I would like to have any figures that suggest the positive elements. For example, a circle. Circle is always positive. Well, one more. A smaller one. We can include one larger circle in this area. That's also could be. Just use the line. And then I'll work a little bit more with my lines. So it's mostly done. So I would like to make the rows here more prominent. And then I'll outline it with a brush marker. And also I will outline the hand itself. Again, I'm using the neurographic line. It's making the shape more visible. Now it's possible to apply colors, to integrate the drawing by using colors. So colors and integration, and I will, since the rose is supposed to be white, I will color it outside. So the darker, my darker blue. So you want a watercolor pencil. They can be used as a dry media or later colored, applied with water. Traditional neurographic art is done with pencils. There is meaning behind it. Apply a little bit different colors. I would like to remain, make the rose remain white. Just emphasize.
Experience darkness and
then and a little bright yellow color, the color of the sun. Oh, really tough. Light pink. Green. A little orange. It's like a so much blue and needs to be some brighter color. Now I will take advantage of watercolor pencils. Thank you so much for joining me in this drawing class. I hope it was a useful exercise for you. I wish you all the best. Good luck with your drawing, and we will see each other online again. Thank you for your attention. Enjoy your neurographic journey.